Yes, hello friends, this is Repost Lectures. We're going to talk about conversion. But before we begin our video, please like my videos, please subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click the notification bell so I don't miss any video on Repost Lectures. Today I'll talk about a conversion theorem. What is conversion theorem? Conversion theorem is a mathematical technique where two signals are combined together to give rise to the what? A third signal. So in conversion, we combine two signals, we combine two inputs, we combine two functions to give a third function. For example, if this is a system. This system is going to be analyzed. Now, this system here, we put there two functions or two inputs or two signals. For example, if this f of t is a what? An input. Then we also have another input, let's say g of t. So this g of t is so an input. So that means this f of t and g of t, they are two inputs or two signals. So these two inputs or two signals will give rise to what? A third output, h of what? T. So this is what we call conversion theorem. So what's the mathematical definition of conversion theorem? So mathematically, the conversion theorem can be defined as, when you convolute or you combine f of t and g of t. Are you understanding? We combine f of t and g of t. So when you combine those two functions, same as an integral from 0 to t. F of u, g of t minus u, du. So this is the mathematical definition of the conversion theorem, where we combine or we convolute two functions or two inputs or two signals, f of t and g of t. We get integral from 0 to t, f of u, g of t minus u, du. So now, since we are combining two signals, that makes the conversion theorem to be used in digital processing. So that means the conversion theorem finds a wider application in digital processing. So this is the mathematical definition of what? The conversion theorem. Now, what if we take the Laplace of this f of t and g of t, those two signals? What do we get? Let's find out. So what if we take the Laplace of f of t and g of t, we get, now, from the definition of Laplace, if I write it from the t domain to the s domain, that means from the t domain, we get f of s. From the t domain, we get g of s. That means we are running away from the t domain going to what? To the s domain. So also g of t in the t domain, the same as g of s in the what? S domain. So these two are very important in the conversion theorem. Thank you very much for watching my video. But now, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to like Repost Lectures. And don't forget to click the notification bell so you don't miss such interesting videos on Repost Lectures. See you next time for an example on conversion theorem.